And now to Wimbledon, where Serena Williams reigns on. Tomorrow morning, the tennis great will attempt another Serena Slam, holding all four Grand Slam titles at once. She won the U.S. Open last year and has since won the Australian and the French Opens. She pulled off the same feat 12 years ago. At 33 years old, Serena is seeded number one, and she faces 21-year-old Garbine Muguruza from Spain in the finals. We're going to look at this latest run and the remarkable career of this woman with Tom Perrotta. He's a sports correspondent for the Wall Street Journal, and he's editor-at-large for Tennis Magazine. Tom Perrotta, welcome. You wrote, I think it was back in November, about how Serena Williams then, you said, had the right to be acclaimed the best of all time. That was 8 months ago, so now it's even more so, right?
It is even more so. It's pretty amazing what she's doing, especially at this age. She's won 7 Grand Slam titles in her 30s. It's really unprecedented.
How do you explain it?
It's an amazing late career resurgence. She's really improved her fitness and her speed and her game a lot in the last few years. She hired a new coach and has really taken off. The thing that's really most amazing about her is the drive that she has at this age. I think most players, when they get into their 30s, a lot of times they burn out. And I think a lot of people expected Serena Williams to burn out much earlier than this because she won when she was so young. It's been against the narrative that everyone really expected that she's been this good for this long.
What's different about her game today than 12 years ago when she pulled off this remarkable feat of all four at one time?
Much better at defense, much steadier, better in rallies, really more reliable and confident in rallies. And, you know, all the other stuff is still there, the kill instinct and all that. The biggest thing that separates her from everybody else and always has for her whole career is her serve. Her serve is better than anybody else on the tour by far. She can ace people seemingly whenever she needs it. It's an amazing weapon, really probably the best serve that the women's game has ever seen.
So what does she face tomorrow in this young 21-year-old opponent?
On paper, it's a big mismatch. This is her first Grand Slam final, and she's only won one tournament in her life. But, you know, she's a very good player, and she's played fearlessly at Wimbledon so far. She's 6 feet tall. She hits very hard. She moves well. She's got a very good serve herself. And she really has nothing to lose out there, and she sounds confident. And she was an admirer of Serena Williams when she was a kid, too, and pretty similar games. And she also beat her once at the French Open a few years ago, actually gave Serena her worst ever loss in a Grand Slam. So she knows that she can do it. This is a much different setting, a much bigger stage, but she has the game to do it. It's a matter of whether she'll get nervous or not.
And as you said, she's beaten her before. How significant in tennis history would it be if Serena Williams were to pull this off tomorrow and I mean, win, again, 4 Grand Slams at one time in 1 year?
It'd be the second time she's done it, which is really remarkable. Right. If she went on to win the U.S. Open, she'd be the first person since Steffi Graf in 1988 to win all 4 in 1 year. And she's only 2 Grand Slam titles behind Graf right now for most in the open era. Serena has 20. Graf has 22. And Serena already has the longest span in that period since 1968 between her first Grand Slam title and her latest one. It's almost 16 years. And if she wins Wimbledon, it'll be the longest in the history of the sport. It's really remarkable. Nobody's been this good for this long in tennis.
Well, just quickly, we don't want to completely ignore the man. Roger Federer had a remarkable performance today. He's the same age as Serena Williams, 33. How do you explain that?
Federer's the player that time forgot. It's pretty amazing. Andy Roddick is here as a commentator for the BBC, and some of us were talking to him after the match. And Roddick's a year younger than Federer, and he's already retired. He was out practicing at Wimbledon today, and he rolled his ankle and, you know, hurt his foot. He was playing with a junior player. And Federer never seems to get hurt. He's incredibly light on his feet. His technique is beautiful. That's really helped him a lot. Also a great serve. And continues to have a lot of fun out there. And he'll be playing Novak Djokovic, who's the number one player in the world. They played in the final last year. Djokovic won in 5 sets. It was a very, very good match. And they've had a great rivalry. Federer leads 20-19. It's very close.
Tom Perrotta with the Wall Street Journal. We thank you.